Welcome back to my channel, welcome back to a brand new video. Today is going to be the first of the moving vlogs, and on today's agenda we're going to be packing up the old house and moving into the new one. So I'm not sure if the empty house tour will already be on this channel or not. If it is, I'll leave it linked. We are planning long-term renovations, extensions on that, so lots of exciting homeware content to come. If that is your kind of thing, then do stick around and subscribe. So I've ordered these boxes. Actually, Tom's ordered these boxes from Amazon. We do need to get some bubble wrap. We need to build all of these boxes, get packing. I have no idea where we're going to start. We're hoping to get in and get the keys this week, so that is why we're starting packing up today. And I hope you enjoy joining us on this very exciting adventure, this little journey of ours. Let's get packing.
Hey, I've been dreaming about you. Every night I see your clearest day. It's just something about the way you make me feel, 'cause I can't concentrate. Anytime you're beside me, yeah, it's what you do to me. I can barely breathe. Hey, I've been thinking about you and all the words that I'm gonna say the next time that I see your pretty face, 'cause I can't concentrate.
Today I have woken up this morning feeling super motivated to get going with the packing. Yesterday all we managed to really get round to doing was building those boxes. I did pop out and buy some parcel tape to tape up the bottoms of them as well, so I did that yesterday. And then for the majority of the day we were working on Tom's room, Tom's wardrobe, having a big clear out. When I got in my car yesterday to pop out to go and get some bubble wrap and parcel tape, got in my car and it told me not to drive and to call the Mercedes service center immediately, and that I was unable to change gear because there was a breakdown detected. I don't know, but Tom just called me then. Mercedes are en route, they're about 15 minutes away, so hoping that they have a look at my car and it's absolutely fine, there's nothing wrong with it, but I just don't want to drive it because, you know, it's under warranty, and if I drive it and then something happens, then that's probably my own fault, because it did tell me not to drive it. In terms of the bubble wrap, I actually ordered some from Amazon Prime, which is coming today anyway. So we kind of held off on all the bubble wrap stuff that needs to be packed, like all the kitchenware. I just decided to do this morning a bit of a packing list of things that I need to do. So for this morning, I'm pretty much just gonna wait until Mercedes gets here, wait until the bubble wrap gets here, and then crack on with doing the kitchen, I think, because that's all the stuff that takes time to wrap each individual item. I'm kind of seeing myself packing up pretty much everything that I don't need within the next month or two. Obviously we're writing on every box what things are and what rooms they need to go in as well. Because we have the luxury of a basement in the new house, I think the majority of the things that we take over initially, the boxes and everything are just gonna go straight down there. It's dry down there and it's fine. It's just like storage currently. That will probably be what we end up doing. So I just want to, clothes and everything, just have enough to last me for like a month. So you'll probably be seeing a lot of the same kind of outfits, a lot of loungewear, a lot of leggings and cardigans and cozy socks and boots as well, because it's getting into the colder months now. I've been catching up with Emily Philpott's old moving vlogs as well, just to get motivated and get in the mood and get all excited. So let me show you the progress that we made yesterday. So this is our landing, the bathroom's in there, and then this, I call Tom's room, it's really just a spare room, but with loads of Tom's clothes in, and this is where he sort of gets ready in the morning. So He's gone through all of these rails and he knows that all of these things on them he is keeping. So rather than pack all these things away in boxes, what I suggested we do is pop them in bin liners. So like grab a bunch about that big, pop it in bin liners, hook the bin liner over so that they're all protected, and just kind of lift them up and lay them on the back of the car. Like this. Here we go. Tom's, he got around to doing one yesterday, although we need some bigger bin bags than that. So then if I take you downstairs, these are all the boxes that we've got stacked up. Oh my God, I came down last night to, and there's a candle lit, which is currently burning over there. I'm kind of wanting to burn through that one so I don't take it. It's the Yankee Candle in Fireside Treats. I got that one from Amazon. It smells delicious. I say delicious because it is actually quite sweet, even though it's got the fireside smoky element to it. The marshmallows make it quite sweet. Anyway, so I came in the door and these boxes were slightly further out. And I got a fright of my life because it was pitch black. I swear there was like someone in here. It scared me. So I've taped up all the bottoms of the boxes and they're ready to go. I actually think we've got enough boxes. I was worried that ordering 10 medium and 10 large wouldn't be enough, but I think it's fine. Oh God, I'm embarrassed to show you the state of this room. Let me just flip you around. Ooh. There's just loads of stuff in this room. And then that is usually the backdrop to my sort of filming videos. I've got loads of new homeware, new in bits, which I think I've shown you the majority of, but there's definitely some new bits in there which I haven't shown you, which I'll probably show you as we get to the new house. We've got kettle and toaster in that box that is brand new, so we don't need to take our old one. Tom Tekken boxes, whatever that means. He's not even taped this up properly. I'll need to retape that. In here he has all of his shoes. And another box of stuff down there, a couple of bags and his cricket stuff. I really don't know where to begin. It's so daunting starting the whole process. I feel like you just have to admit the fact that it's going to be a mess and you're going to be living out of bags and boxes for a while. But that's just the way it's going to be. So I'm not letting that stress me out, but I am like thinking, oh, where to begin? Also, you may have noticed along the floor here, this bottom section of this kitchen has come off. And you can like kind of prop it up against it, but Tom's replacing that and everything before he sells this house anyway. Same with the door here for the fridge. This we've taken off, I've got the screws there just initially. It's meant to go here, but the fridge needed pulling out to sort that bottom bit out. So we're just ignoring the fact that the kitchen is an absolute state right now in terms of the actual cabinets and everything as well. We've just kind of been living with it. I feel like I'm just procrastinating and I should just get going. I need some sellotape as well.
Go crazy.
It's the end of the day, and well, it's not really the end of the day. It is the end of packing up today, I think. I'm pretty much done with the kitchen. Mom's gonna cook us dinner. What are you cooking?
Pasta, yeah.
I just want to give a lowdown on what our cupboards are looking like. I've put all of our essentials here. This is the food cupboard, so we need to go through that and see what we need. Those are empty, those are empty. This is empty, and then this just has glassware now. Oh, and then like coffees and things. We'll take these ones, but I'm not gonna bother taking the pint glasses because it's kind of embarrassing serving someone a drink in a pint glass. So I'll get some nice,
What?
What
if they want a pint?
Woohoo!
What if they want a pint for it?
If they want a pint, they can have a nice glass.
Yeah, but I bet we don't have anything else that will contain a pint. Do you know what I mean?
And then I'm just going to put on last night's Love Island just in the background whilst Tom's cooking because I actually missed it. In fact, it's probably finished by the time this vlog's up anyway. Love Island USA. And that is the update pretty much for today. So we're going to have a nice dinner with minimal crockery and pots.
Have we got another pot for the pasta? Yeah, this one, yeah.
Yeah, we've got one pot, one pan. No, one...
Do you want to get me some boiling water on? Do you reckon you can sort that?
I reckon I can sort that. We've got one pan and one frying pan. Oh no, what have you done? Wait, did you not know that? I feel like that reminds me of a film, that. I don't know what. You know when the sausages are all...
Human centipede.
Oh no. No. Chef Tom. He sliced off his finger the other day, so I can't watch him chop. Goes through me.
How are you going to make boiled water?
I'll boil the water now. The only boxes we have left. So maybe we are gonna run out of boxes, we'll see. But this is the progress. It's been quite a long day packing in this front room, really. All these sort of big items, we'll get the removals to take. That is so heavy. I am so glad I'm not having to do that. And then same with like that whole unit. But what I've done is I've emptied it and packed up all of the bits that were in these drawers in these boxes here. This is the kitchen as well. Pretty much everything's boxed up bar the things that we're either gonna leave or things that are just for like the few days that we're gonna be here before we get the keys and start moving things in. And then we've got all of our food which we're trying to work our way through as well. So tonight, this is gonna be pretty much our moving diet for a while whilst we save up our pennies. Beans on toast, such a classic. Ooh, classic white with sourdough. Interesting. Oh my God, these are the best things ever for dessert. They're little chocolate shaped, well, they look like Christmas puddings, but they're little chocolate truffles from Booths. So good. I look really tired. I think it's my makeup. Going through some beauty bits. Oh, tired. It's like a workout. My back hurts. I feel gross. Need a shower. Need to take my makeup off. You okay? Oh, that was a struggle for you to get. Oh God, that's a sign of old age, that. And you have to make a noise to stand up. These shoe boxes are from Home Bargains. I think they're literally like less than a pound each. So really good
for like being able to stack them and store them.
We'll misbehave.
I did get these recently actually, which I've not shown you before. They're actually kind of similar to these ones. So I love Adidas trainers. They're like probably my favorite. So I've got these, they're called the Pure Boost. Both of these pairs of shoes are from Amazon, so I'll link them below. And then these newer ones I've yet to wear. They're definitely more white, so I will save them because let's face it, the shoes that I'm going to be wearing over the next few days, if they're originally white, they're not going to stay white. So that is what they look like. I love the kind of design on the front, this little like label. These are called the Sense Boost Go Running Shoes. I got them in a 6.5 and Tom likes them, which is great because Tom's the shoe
snob.
When it comes to getting good trainers, I've had a few pairs in the past that he's been a bit, thought they were a bit questionable, let's just say that.
Nor standing still.
Admit there is something quite therapeutic about packing. I get that it's stressful for a lot of people, but I don't mind it. I quite enjoy it. I like having clear outs. I like decluttering. As I'm going, I'm sort of making sure that I don't take anything that I don't want, whereas Tom's not as ruthless as me. I feel like that's the military upbringing in me because we've had to move every 2.5 years of my whole life. It's made me pretty good. It's made me pretty good at being ruthless when it comes to clear outs. I'm quite good at just getting rid. I don't hold on to things that I don't need. I don't have that like sentimental attachment to a lot of products. Especially if it's just like clothes and shoes and things. I especially doing what I do because we're quite fortunate in that we get gifted quite a lot. I look at things as, you know, yeah, I might like them, but do I need them? And if not, give them to a better home, give them to friends and family, someone who will appreciate it more than it just going in the back of my wardrobe and me potentially never wearing it. Just done a big charity shop drop this morning, which actually I was lucky because they've not been taking donations for a while, our local charity shop. So I actually called them up this morning just to double check that they were open to collecting or having some donations dropped off, and they were. Shoes. God, oh God. Oh yeah, okay. Okay, maybe I can't lift it, but even if I can just lift it up like that, someone can deal with this. So I just flip you around and show you my wardrobe and how that is currently looking. Like I have just said, I did just do a big clear out recently and just donated a load to charity. Just in between the move and everything like that, as much as I'd love to list everything on Depop, I really don't have the time and place to store everything, pack everything up individually and sell out. So with that being said, if ever you do see anything that I ever feature that you think that you would like to buy, just pop me a message because more often than not, it might be something that, yeah, I might be willing to sell it. I might have worn it a couple of times, you know, not necessarily need it, just message me on Instagram. And as and when I'm in the new house and I next have a wardrobe clear out, I'll probably do a Depop sale because then I'll be a bit more settled. I need to find out where my local new post office is gonna be. I need to do a to-do list. I need to make sure I know exactly the things that I need changing my address on, passport, driving license, and all that sort of stuff. New doctors, new dentists, new opticians. Anyway, let me show you what my wardrobe is currently looking like. So I have two drawers full of things at the bottom. I say two, I've actually got two on each side. Lots of loungewear, pajamas and little basics in there. Oh, and leggings. That's actually just a big White Company box that is, I think it's currently empty. So I might use that to store bedding in or something. I'm not sure yet, but obviously I'm going to take that. All of my bottoms, all of my dresses type things, blazers and tops and jumpers. Oh my god, look how cozy this one is. This one's from everything5pounds.com. Love it so much, it's so soft. I'm after a really chunky knit cardigan actually still, that's a lighter colour. I do have the grey one, which I was just wearing a minute ago, and I do have another grey one. But I really want like a sand coloured one or a cream coloured one. Quite a long one, just in that kind of fabric as well, like a real thick, cozy chenille type fabric. So if you have any recommendations of where I could get good quality ones, then do let me know. So this is it, we've packed up our lives, we are ready to go.
Is that it?
So we're getting the keys today, so it's a big day. I just don't know timing wise. If the empty house tour is already up, I'll leave it linked. This is load one of probably about, how many trips do you reckon we're going to have to?
10.
10 drives.
No, maybe not.
With my car, your mum's car's bigger. And then we'll get removals for all the big furniture in. So by this time next week.
Yeah.
We'll be fully in, sleeping there.
Should be, yeah.
Only came out with one drink. Why hot chocolate that? For you. Pumpkin spice latte, all sold out.
Why don't you just get a normal latte?
I just didn't want to succumb. So I ended up with sparkling water. I'm also not, I don't know. I did get banana bread though. And I got you a cookie. Yeah, that's yours. On the road, Jack, don't you come back no more. And this is the weather for today. And now we're running late. Lots of exciting homeware updates to come, and I'll leave my Instagram homeware account where I'll do more regular daily updates. Because these videos are filmed like over a longer period, so if you want current in the know with what is going on, then Freya Frankton Home over on my Instagram. And if you want to know how Tom's getting on, up to, with your flat development, go and plug yourself. What should they do?
Sorry?
What should they do?
Do what?
Oh my god, he wasn't even listening.
Try not to.
Who should they follow to see your updates?
Mode Your Living.
Mode Your Living, woo! Anyway, I'm going to enjoy my banana.
Last update 6 months ago.
I know, he's rubbish. I keep pushing him for content, but he's just not, he doesn't have Instagram, he doesn't have Facebook. You don't do that kind of thing, do you? Which I quite like. I quite like the fact that you don't have social media.
I've only got plenty of fish.
So, we have made it. We've just pulled up. We've actually not just pulled up. We've been here a while. But we have just kind of handed over, done the little keys handover. Just, I'm so excited for this new journey. I'm so excited. I've lost for words. Tom's just headed in. We're actually going to unload all these boxes now. So this is on our agenda for the next hour or so. Then we're going to go grab some lunch and film empty house tour, do all that jazz, and then say goodbye to this property until tomorrow. We'll be back with another carload full of stuff. So I'm actually going to close off this vlog here. This moving vlog one, which I hope you enjoyed. Obviously, lots more content to come in terms of the move and the new house. So if you are interested and want to stick around, do subscribe and hit that notification bell to be notified when I next upload a moving vlog. And if you do happen to have any questions about where we're living, about the house, about our plans, just stay tuned for upcoming videos, and you know my DMs are always open over on Instagram. So yeah, thank you so much for your support on this house move so far. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for my next video. Bye guys.